India, the land of the mystique and modern. Where monuments galore speak of the rich history and heritage. Where diversity and vibrancy of its people speak of its rich culture and civilization. Where new modern buildings and industries speak of its fast progress and development. India, the seventh largest nation in the world and the second most populated country, has 28 states, each one different in terms of its geography, people and culture. The beauty of diversity and unity in diversity, that is India. But this is also the country's biggest challenge, especially when it comes to tackling the problem of illiteracy. Although the literacy percentage has increased from 14 in 1947 at the time of country's independence to 18.3 in 1951 to 28.3 in 1961 to 34.4 in 1971 to 43.5 in 1981, it went up to 52% in 1991 and 62% in 1997. But the fact that 38% of its population does not know how to read and write is a major concern. Concern it has always been, and hence keeping in mind the diversity and uniqueness of the country, the different languages and customs of its people, the different geographical sites and historical background, the typical habits and interests of communities, and the difficulties of poverty and backwardness that non-formal education programs have been devised. What really are these different features? States like Mizoram and Kerala have literacy rate of about 80%, while states like Bihar and Rajasthan have literacy rates below 40%. Four states, the Hindi-speaking states, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, account for half the illiterate population in the country. The differential in urban and rural literacy was also very high. In 1961, the urban literacy rate was 54.4%, but it was only 22.5% in rural areas. In 1971, it was 60.2% in the urban areas and 27.9% in the rural areas. In 1981, it was 67.2% in the urban areas, but 36% in the rural areas. And in 1991, it was 73.1% in the urban areas and 44.7% in the rural areas. Thus, a separate strategy was formed for separate places and conditions. A unique campaign approach was adopted by mobilizing people from all walks of life by motivating and convincing them of the link between literacy and improving quality of life. This experiment was launched in Ernakulam, located in Kerala, the southernmost state of India. Using society leaders, elders, youth and women, this multi-pronged approach led to creating awareness and awakening, sensitizing and inspiring everyone. Kala Jathas, a band of local dancers, singers, musicians, moved from one village to another, mobilizing masses and conveying the message of illiteracy.
La 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 la
All kinds of forms were used, street plays, local theatre, puppetry and folk songs to create an environment conducive to learning.
ਕੁੜੀ ਨੂੰ ਪਿੰਡ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਪੜਾ ਲਾਂਗੇ
ਕਿਵੇਂ ਪੜਾ ਲਾਂਗੇ
ਤੈਨੂੰ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਤਾ ਕੀ ਉਹ ਪਿੰਡ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਖਰਾ ਸੰਮਤੀ ਨੇ ਸਕੂਲ ਖੋਲ੍ਹੇ ਹੋਏ ਆ ਜਿੰਨੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਅਨਪੜ੍ਹ ਰਹੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਪੜ੍ਹ ਰਹੇ ਆ ਆਪਾਂ ਕੁੜੀ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਪੜਾ ਲਾਂਗੇ
ਐਕਸੈਸਿੰਗ ਦੀਸ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਵਿਲੇਜ ਪੀਪਲ ਥਰੂ ਦੇਅਰ ਕਲਚਰਲ ਰੂਟਸ ਐਂਡ ਟ੍ਰੈਡੀਸ਼ਨਸ ਬ੍ਰੌਟ ਇਨ ਕੁਇਕ ਰਿਜ਼ਲਟਸ ਐਂਡ ਹੈਂਸ ਦ ਕੈਂਪੇਨ ਅਪਰੋਚ ਵਾਸ ਅਡਾਪਟਡ ਇਨ ਸੈਵਰਲ ਅਦਰ ਡਿਸਟ੍ਰਿਕਟਸ Villagers gullible to superstitions understood through these simple performances that illness does not go away by shooing the spirit away. Need-based and utility themes are also being added. Here the adverse effect of throwing polythene bags, which are non-biodegradable, is being demonstrated. And here the poor slum people are being wooed to join the non-formal system of learning. Learning is not the stress on functional literacy of 3 R's, which is reading, writing and arithmetic, but participation in the development process, skill improvement for enhanced economic status and imbibing values of small families, gender equity, health and hygiene and environmental conservation. Volunteers became the vital key to the entire process. Displaying the rare spirit of serving the community, volunteers from within the society worked for no monetary benefit but personal satisfaction.
पहले तो वो इनकार करते थे जब मेरे को स्कूल से गाइडेंस मिली ना भी पढ़ाना है फिर मैं सबके घर एक बार नहीं 10-10 बार गई मैंने कहा अगर आप रात को भी आएंगे ना कि मेरी सोसाइटी में हो जाएंगे मैं अकेली है वहां पढ़ी लिखी और कोई नहीं है मेरे सारे पिछले मेरे पेरेंट्स जेड़े सब पढ़े लिखे हैं मैं ही ये छोटे से परिवार ही ना चाही है अनपढ़ है बाकी सारे हैं ते मैंने बड़ा शौक सेगा मैं ते अपने पिंड बड़र दे विच 60 दिन फ्री सेवा कीती
दे ब्रॉट अंडर द लर्निंग अम्ब्रेला एडल्ट्स ऑफ ऑल एजेस ऑल्दो द एम वाज टू कवर ऑल एडल्ट्स इन द 15 टू 35 ईयर फ्रेम मेन एंड वुमेन इन देयर 60s एंड 70s वांटिंग टू लर्न प्रूव्ड Age is no bar for learning. While the total literacy campaigns, which through its 10 million volunteers successfully made millions literate, post-literacy campaigns were launched to prevent relapse. Training in income generating skills was added to the program. Realizing that poor people who survived on daily wages could not give up hours of working to attend a regular class, learning was taken to their workplaces where along with say weaving cloth, making carpets, doing embroidery work or making baskets, people were introduced to the three R's.
We are having our centers at the nearest end of the learner spot. We are having centers at the very closer to the habitations of this illiterate women folks area. And we do the classes, we are taking classes at their convenience.
India, with the beauty of snow-capped mountains and the golden sands, with gushing rivers and vast plain lands, is a tourist attraction. But the difficult and different terrains inhabited by culturally different people was a formidable challenge for non-formal education. Thus, area-specific programs were evolved. For instance, Gujjars living in these Uttar Pradesh hills spent 6 months in the mountains and then 6 months in plains during the snow season, primarily for grazing their cattle. Thus, volunteers traveled with these people wherever they went to conduct learning classes after they were through with their daily activities.
Shikar,
Shahid,
Shahid,
Shivalik,
Shivalik,
Khuda,
Khuda,
Quran,
Quran,
Alam,
वह भी बिना पैसे का,
वह भी बिना पैसे का,
रोशनी,
रोशनी,
हाँ,
हाँ,
तभी यह शादी हुई,
तभी यह शादी हुई,
मेरी भी
यही मांग
थी,
यही मांग थी।
होता ये है कि जो हमने मेहनत की यहाँ पढ़ाया, अगर हम ऊपर नहीं जाएंगे इनके साथ तो बच्चे उसे भूल जाते हैं, फिर प्रॉब्लम हमारे सामने आती है, दोबारा फिर उसे रिपीट करना पड़ता है हमें, तो इसलिए हम वहाँ भी इनके साथ जाते हैं और 6 महीने इनके साथ रहते हैं और फिर पैदल ही इनके साथ नीचे प्लेन में आ जाते हैं।
In fact, in places like Rajasthan, where traveling in a desert area is very difficult, it is only the spirit of volunteerism that led to the spread of literacy. For not only are the houses here scattered, but each village consisting of few huts is miles away from the next one, making it very difficult for volunteers to travel. But they did, and hence the success. Again, the issue of language differences in different states was tackled by devising material in local languages. Care was taken to weave messages in typical folklore that dominated the area. For instance, learners in forest areas were taught words with reference to trees and animals. And everywhere, the success was due to the participation of people, especially women's participation.
पति रोक रहा था अंदर से बाहर नहीं जाने के लिए, तो हम पति को समझा बुझा के से अपना समाज को सेवा कर रहे हैं, माँ बहन को, भाई बहन को, सब से कुछ से अपना समझ आ जाए, दस्तखत करने के लिए कम से कम।
Women who had been deprived of formal schooling are being provided a great opportunity to learn reading, writing and improving skills.
अब जो मौका मिला है साक्षरता कार्यक्रम के नाते पढ़ने के लिए, तो वो इसमें बढ़ चढ़ के भागीदारी कर रही हैं। इस उनको लग रहा है कि हमें एक मौका मिल गया है, तो हम इसमें उसको किसी तरीके से हासिल करना है, उस चीज़ को पढ़ना लिखना जान लें और सारी चीज़ें समझ लें, तो इसलिए वो पुरुषों से कहीं आगे आ करके और इसमें हिस्सेदारी कर रही हैं। जितने भी हमारे महिलाओं के सेंटर हैं वो बहुत अच्छे चल रहे हैं।
महिला तो घर के अंदर बांधी रहती थी, वे सोचती हम जेल के तरह बैठे हुए हैं, अपना अधिकार को समझ नहीं पाती थी, पुरुषों के अधिकार में रहती थी जूते। हम लोग संगठन बनाने के बाद ऐसा बोले कि क्यों बने घर में रहेगी, पुरुषों के अधिकार में रहेगी तो क्या लाद जूता खाते रहेगी, अगर हम लोग महिला एक संगठन कर लेंगे तो महिला का विकास होगा, पुरुषों के अधिकार में क्यों रहेंगे, क्यों रहेंगे, क्यों ना अपना साक्षर बन के अपना हम लोग कमा सकते हैं। कोई भी योजना अभी क्या महिला हमारे यहाँ वीडियो है, सीओ बहुत सारी सर ठेकेदार ही महिला करती है, डॉक्टर भी, इंजीनियर, क्या हम क्यों नहीं हम लोग भी अपना अधिकार पकड़े।
Today, 62% of the participants are females. The female rate of literacy has grown faster than the male rate. The ratio is almost 10:8. women are in the forefront of milk cooperatives and women's saving groups. In many such places, whenever these women members get together for learning, they collect rupees 10 to rupees 20 per month from each member. This is the bank called Didi in their local parlance, where members can withdraw during need and without notice or hassles. Such is the progress that this woman's group is planning to put the money in a commercial bank and earn interest which can be useful to the members. Women involvement, apart from contributing to women empowerment and gender equity, has helped better enrollment of children in schools, improvement in health and hygiene standards, and in a way, family welfare.
मुझे बहुत कुछ फायदा हो रही है जैसे मैं अब सामान लेने के लिए दुकान में जाती हूँ तो और कुछ भी सामान खरीद कर ले आती हूँ उस सामान का पैसा भी मैं बराबर चुका सकती हूँ मेरे बच्चे भी अच्छे तरह से पढ़ रहे हैं और पढ़ रहे हैं और अच्छा शिक्षा प्राप्त कर रही है मैं अपने बच्चे को अच्छी तरह से पढ़ा कर अच्छी तरह से शिक्षा प्राप्त कर देती हूँ और देती रहूँगी
One of the reasons for school dropouts being monotonous syllabus and uninspiring teachers, the stress of non-formal education was a learning-friendly approach. It wasn't an outsider teacher teaching ABC or 1, 2, 3. It was their own fellow brother or sister who conversed with them, shared their joys and sorrows, empathized and identified with them.
Awareness that has been created has been quite substantial. So that is where we have succeeded. That is, the need for literacy has been created. That is number one. Number two, we have also succeeded in ensuring that a large number of school children who have been dropping out of schools are sent back to schools. So that has been a major success. So a drive has been launched to ensure that many of the children who have dropped out for various reasons, like poverty, or for that reason, like the non-willingness of the parents to send their children to school, have by and large been curbed. And quite a large number of children, a large percentage of children now going to school.
Thus, the entire scenario was everyone is learning. Students from the teacher, yes, but teacher from the student too. In this village of Northeast, here is a teacher come student. Reaching the unreached. Reaching over 90% of the country's villages and population, reaching even to the remotest corners, reaching the most educationally deprived states was significant. Here, the need for an effective and periodic monitoring and evaluation system was felt. External visits are organized to campaign districts and performance reports are put out in a simplified format. Monthly monitoring meetings are also held at various levels. Here, apart from discussing the problems encountered, steps to accelerate the pace of non-formal education are discussed. Not only is this participatory, but done in the true non-formal spirit. Evaluations are done by external agencies for objectivity. And the impact of all this has been tremendous. Study findings reveal that enrollment of boys and girls in the age group 5 to 15 years has been significantly higher in neoliterate households as compared to children in illiterate households. There is an 8 to 10% increase in enrollment of girls.
The main aspect about this program is we take children who are involved in hazardous industries like the BD industry, the match industry. We put them into these schools, and these are special schools. Children are taught by way of song. They're taught in a way that will make them feel happy that they are in class. And after 1 year or after 2 years, we give them a special exam. And whichever class they are able to fit into in a regular school, they put into that.
Education among girls has dramatically increased thanks to the awareness among neo-literate parents that girls need to be educated for the betterment of the family and society.
लड़कियों तो कहते हैं कि जितना पढ़ ले जो मास्टर रानी बन जाए तो हमारे को बहुत अच्छा लगेगा और लड़के को लड़के को कहते हैं कि कोई अच्छी नौकरी, वो लड़का तो बोलता है कि हम पुलिस की नौकरी करेंगे।
बड़ा लड़का तो कहता है मैं कुआसर बनूंगा, वो छोटा वाला कहता है कि मैं कोई लीडर बनूंगा।
लड़कियां क्या कहती हैं?
लड़की कहती है कोई मैं अस्पताल से कोई नर्स बन जाऊंगी, कोई बड़ा अच्छा काम करूंगी, अपनी जिंदगी में गरीब जनता है बिना कोई भलाई के लिए काम कर सकती हूं।
देयर हैज बीन अ फास्टर मूवमेंट ऑन द पाथ ऑफ जेंडर इक्विटी एंड एम्पावरिंग वुमेन स्पेशली एज रिगार्ड्स डिसीजन मेकिंग। The women who did not come out of their veils now are contesting elections.
महिलाएं बहुत आगे आई हैं और उनको हर क्षेत्र में आगे आने का मौका मिल रहा है। अपने आप में वे आत्मनिर्भर होते जा रही हैं। उनको लगता है कि हम महिला केवल चूल्हे चौके तक सीमित ही नहीं हैं, बल्कि इससे कहीं बढ़कर वो हर काम हम कर सकते हैं जो पुरुष लोग करते हैं। और ये जागरूकता सभी तरह देखने को, सभी फील्ड में, सभी क्षेत्र में देखने को मिल रहा है।
In fact, in the period of 1991 to 1997, female literacy rate has gone up by 11% as against increase in male literacy rate of 9%. There has been a demonstrable decline in fertility and infant mortality rates. Skills development and training has increased opportunities for people to start a new enterprise or a vocation. These women from a remote Bihar village took on the male-dominated job of fixing hand pumps because hand pumps facilitated their lives. Increased income generation has, of course, meant improvement in quality of life and giving better opportunities of growth to their children. And as far as the statistics go, a survey carried out by the National Sample Survey Organization in 1998 revealed a 10 percent points jump in literacy rates from 1991 to 1997. From 52% literacy rate in 1991, it was 62% in 1997. The huge differential in urban and rural literacy rates has also narrowed from 31.9% in 1961 to 28.4% in 1991 and 24% in 1997. The achievement is significant because despite the population growth rate of 1.8% per annum, the number of illiterates shows a marked decline of 60.5 million between 1991 and 2001. Overall, there is tremendous betterment in social and personal development. But learning is a continuous process. And the world is moving towards a knowledge society. India is moving in this direction too, and the trend is encouraging. The literacy growth is already 2% per annum. At this rate, India could reach the sustainable threshold level of 75% literacy rate by 2006. Thus, continuing education or lifelong education is the goal. Informal or formal libraries where people can access newspapers, magazines and books are part of the process.
Ladies and boys, they come once a week and sit together here in the library hall and read the books and return. If they need, they can take it home for a week and return it on the next following week. Afterwards, new books are come. I will inform them that these are the new books. You can take it and read it and return it.
And part of the process are also these extracurricular activities like chess playing in Andhra Pradesh's far-flung village to matka or pots race in this Rajasthan village. Encouraging people to revive old traditions and folk songs are these centers in Maharashtra.
Hey!
Education in its true sense became an enabler for these women from Madhya Pradesh to become owners from mere laborers. These women used to break stones in a quarry for their livelihood. But inspired, they formed a cooperative and purchased a quarry. These neoliterates are like their other millions of neoliterate brothers and sisters in the country. Brilliant examples of what learning can do. It creates vibrant, thinking, knowledgeable, and forward-looking individuals. The ultimate goal,